I don't usually listen in on private conversations, but I didn't want to just barge in like I always do. There was something about that argument between Nella and a friend. I can't put my finger on it, but it felt odd. Off, somehow. Well, none of my business. Still, when I asked Nella about Hannah, she was very evasive. Why tell me to not ask any questions? What was that about? I'll have to ask Nella again when she's in a better mood. In a few days. A week, maybe. Yeah, let's make that 1 week. Or two. Two sounds good. Right. Do I go home then, I guess? There's not really much else to do.
Safe.
Dependent. Oh, sorry.
Europe needs compassion.
He looks really familiar.
Change. Europe needs a...
I've seen him somewhere before. Do I know her? Sure, I've seen her before. She's... Nope, can't place her. She looks familiar. Who is that? Do I know him? Who is that? Do I know him? I've seen him somewhere before. He looks really familiar. He looks really familiar.
So basically we're seeing people we've saved already? But I guess there's not much more we can do right now.
So I says to him, I says, you can't pass through here, Bruder. You need to turn back and head home.
So what did he do?
I guess anyway, I'm not sure. This is fairly close by, so let's just do this and see if Reza's gotten home. No. Well, that was not where we wanted to go then. What more was I supposed to be doing? I know there was something.
You look like you could need some directions, miss.
Should I give the receipt back to Nella? Is that the thing? Not entirely sure, actually.
So I says to him, I says, you can't pass through here, Bruder. You need to turn back and head home.
That, or do I need to go talk to Queenie again? That's also a possibility. It's a little bit far-fetched, though. I guess I can't.
He looks really familiar. I've seen him somewhere before. She looks familiar. I've seen her before. She's... Nope, can't place her.
Down in the dumps. Trouble staying focused.
Hannah Roth will have to wait, no matter how worried Queenie may be. Nella's in a foul mood, and I'm not about to go poking her with a sharp stick. Closed. And no buzzer. I'm guessing you need an appointment? Eye checkpoint. I haven't filed the paperwork to get through there.
I know this has nothing to do with anything, but I just need to check this out.
Well, what do I do now? I don't know what to do now.
Okay, fair enough. I figured I was gonna try to see What the heck? Do I go?
Map! Get your map here! Map!
Nella is the only Marxist I know. I guess she has the energy and commitment of a whole apartment building. Still just one vote, though.
Then again, I haven't been sure about where to go for the last hour, I guess. Well, that's...
It's between Wolf and Ominska, isn't it?
Oh,
Gross and Rebus are not even competing.
Yeah, the Alliance has screwed up too often.
Crowboy's here to help you find your way in Propast.
It's warm and tingly. Odd.
Let's see if we can.
I don't even know where to start.
Refresh yourself with the refresher.
I'm just a guy with guitar.
The Collapse, August 8th, 2209. The day everything went to hell.
You know, she gets
I remember
a lot
only
the
fragments.
Ego, but Reza is straight up.
It was a scary day.
Everything's in the same place anyway, so let them, more or less anyway. So let's talk to Reza. And.
Finished at work?
Affirmative. Where's everyone?
Following up on stories, leaving me to run the ship. Weren't you campaigning this afternoon?
What does it look like I'm doing?
Not campaigning?
Sure, that's...
Don't you dare be late.
Right, so nothing new there. Actually, can I hand him the receipt to see if he knows anything? No, of course not. That would be too easy. There's nothing more, is there? No. 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 Bollocks. So we could go talk to Queenie, or we could go talk to Baruti. I don't really think any one of them have anything interesting to say, but...
an interactive tourist map of Propas. He looks really familiar.
Hey, you lost? No problem. I can give you directions to anywhere in Propas.
I think we've already said all we can say to Baruti, but... What?
Mr. London ain't too happy with how you're messing about in his barrios, Sozy.
Easy, cousin.
I ain't I'm your not... cousin, mate. I ain't your mate, neither. Mr. London says you ain't never asked for his blessings, Colo. Mr. London, he ain't too happy about that, him. Mr. London says it's disrespectful.
Tell Mr. London that I'm not messing with anything. I'm just running a political campaign. Maybe if we could have a civil discussion about this, instead
Oi, Essie! You talk to me, not to Mr. London. No one talks to Mr. London. And there's no discussion to be had. We have no use for your commie comrades in Propast. In this barrio, we vote Wolf.
Oh, I see what's going on. This isn't about Tef or respect, is it?
Hey, let him go. Wait, what was that mean?
Otherwise, don't get involved, Suka. You just get your fresh messed up. Wouldn't look too good with a broken piff, huh?
I didn't understand any of that, but if you don't let him go, I'm calling the police.
A pella? Shite a minute. You think the police are going to interfere? Do you know who this is? This is Mr. London. And he owns the Buller in Propast. Now fuck off before I get total anger pissed and decide to...
一个旅行的商人沿途为他的商品叫卖，他卖武器和盔甲。有一日，他来到一个村入面，里面住着一位伟大的军人。我的盾牌，商人话，非常坚固，无论乜嘢武器都嵌入，佢可以保护你不受任何伤害。 我嘅长矛，商人话锋利无比，无论乜嘢一刺就穿，将你嘅敌人即刻打到喺地上。咁点可以啊？伟大嘅军人问道：你有一个乜嘢都无法刺穿嘅盾牌，同埋一个乜嘢都能刺穿嘅长矛，佢哋点样可以同时存在啊
？I don't speak Cantonese。
商人攞起佢嘅盾牌同埋长矛。 可唔可以同时存在并不重要，你个老閪！佢冲过去，用长矛将军人刺死，因为佢哋喺我手上，我话事。
Just let him go, please. He's harmless.
'And let that be a lesson to you, Kutas. This is Mr. London's barrio, and the sooner you get that through your cocoa, the less mal you'll need to deal with.
Interesting. Are you all right?
Jesus, Baruti, are you okay?
I think so. Thanks for speaking up, Zoe. I appreciate it. Although, I'm not sure it was the smartest thing to do. You're on his radar now.
I couldn't just stand by and watch. Are you sure you're all right?
I am. But I'm not going anywhere tonight. I'm just going to watch Leia stream out from the office.
Do you need anything? You don't have to stay here by yourself, you know. I can stay, or you can come home with me.
I'm fine, Sissy. Really. They were just trying to scare me. Mission accomplished. They're not coming back. Not today, at least. We can worry about tomorrow, tomorrow.
Okay. About Queenie and...
Let's talk about that tomorrow, too. Right now, I just want to sit down with a cup of hot tea and enjoy a rousing speech.
I understand. But Baruti, please lock the door and ring if there's anything.
I won't argue with you there. See you on Thursday, Sissy.
Take care, Baruti.
There we go.
Our campaign office.
It's a hole in the wall, but Baruti has made it a very presentable hole in the wall.
Right, do I go back home now then?
Shalom, can I help you find something? Next time!
I'm actually a bit worried about Frida. She's on the Dreamer all the time.
Now that I'm still here, I'm just going to make sure that we don't have to talk to Reza before we go home. Because otherwise I'd just run home and there's no one there and then whatever. Oh, come on. Come on. Here we go. Oh, jeez. Okay, Reza's gone home. Here we go. Now we can probably go home. Hopefully.
Oh, come on.
My poor computer. It's so slow. I really need to try to set aside some money to upgrade this poor thing. I think the processor is starting to feel a little old.
You know, she gets a lot on the adder, but Rebus is straight up. I think I'm voting Manifesto.
Down in the dumps, trouble staying focused.
Dreamed all my life, I stay awake.
I really like the music and the ambience in this game. At least so far. It's been rather nice.
Are you really going to wear that? Precious.
Like it or not, and I don't, you can't deny that Wattie's doing a really good job selling their dream machines.
Let's see. Oh, sorry, lady. Didn't mean to.
Dream junkies around. The city should do
something. Move along. Nothing to see here.
Go away, pigeons.
Man, Crowboy's here to help you find your way in ProPass.
Let's see. Are you home, Reza? Guess so by this music. There we go.
Hey.
Ooh, smells good. What are you making?
Risotto. Come over here.
I got you.
Nice to see you too. I needed that.
Why? What's going on?
We had a real scare at the campaign office.
What happened?
Baruti got pushed around by Mr. London's goons, and London himself.
Jesus, is he okay?
He's fine. He's probably fine.
How about you? Are you okay?
I'm okay. They didn't touch me.
But you got involved?
I had to. I couldn't just let them do that to Baruti.
I really wish you'd stayed out of it. You don't know what those people are capable of.
They're just cowards.
Cowards with the might of the Syndicate behind them.
Still just cowards. Look, I'll be okay. They wanted to scare Baruti. Nothing's going to happen. They're not going to come after me.
About earlier. I'm sorry I pushed your therapy buttons. I didn't mean to pry.
Don't worry about it, Rez. I was tired. I'm okay talking. Really. And I do feel better.
It's helping?
It's helping. Mostly because of you.
Let's hope you don't change your mind after this risotto.
How was your day?
Not as interesting as yours. I published that bingo piece. Now I'm following up the leads on the clampdown.
It's getting ridiculous out there. Everyone's on edge.
I know the campaign work is important to you, but you need to be careful about getting involved in local affairs. Even Sully doesn't want us to write too much about what's happening here in ProPast.
If you stop reporting things because you're afraid of what will happen, you're censoring yourself.
We need to pick our battles. Like that Mr. London business. He shakes businesses down, runs the local black market. Bad, sure, but not corporate-level bad. Or Kaiser Constantine bad.
I guess.
I'm not happy about it either, but sometimes you need to let the small fish go in order to catch the bigger fish.
I get that. Maybe I'm an idealist.
We both are. But I'm also a realist. And I really wish you'd drop the campaign work. Hey, come over here and taste this.
I don't like his tone, and it's not the first time we've had this argument. Sometimes Reza can be so controlling. I don't like it. I don't like his tone. It's not the first time we've had this argument, and I'm tired. I want to have a quiet evening. I should just...
How was it?
It's good. Really good. I can't wait to eat. I'll pay you back afterwards.
For what?
Cooking the best dinners, being the best boyfriend, knowing how to make me feel better.
Do we have to wait until after dinner?
Won't the risotto be ruined?
Is that important?
Not in the slightest. Don't just say you love me.
Wow, hello. Don't just say you love me, show me. Well, that can't be good, can it? Jeesh. And the plot thickens. There's more to this than we think. The house in between.
What's Saga up to, Magnus?
Sleeping? Playing? Plotting our downfall? I don't know. She's in a crib and she's been suspiciously quiet.
Good. That's good.
And you're not listening to a word I'm saying. How's the story coming?
Don't ask.
All right. So when can I read it?
Don't ask.
All right then.
Let's try it again. Yes. Ow. Oh, hello. What you want?
Hey, is there anything you want me to bring back this time?
Do we have to talk about that right now?
I'm leaving tomorrow.
I don't like it when you leave.
I worry when you leave.
I thought the whole point of building this house was so that we wouldn't have to worry so much anymore.
Oh, I'll always worry. But I'll always come back to you. This is our anchor, in time and space. In all worlds, past, present, and future.
You're starting to sound like a real estate agent.
Recently renovated, low interest rates, unbound from space and time, never twice the same neighborhood, comes with one beautiful baby girl and a sexy, willing wife.
Sexy, but not always so willing.
Just focus on the stew, dear.
You better let me read what you've written afterwards.
Not a chance, now shush.
Thank you.
Hey, what are you doing out of your crib? How did you pull that off? Let's get you back safe and sound.
No! No! I'm getting out of here. Oh. I guess I can't really do much over here. Can't reach, can I? Nice, barely. No. These stubby arms. Okay. And I can't get to that. Okay, fair enough. I guess we just need to walk quietly around here. Okay.
Are you out again? You're a clever one, you are. Now be a good girl and stay put.
Yeah, I guess I'm not going that way. There we go. I thought I'd be smart about it, but apparently that's not very smart. So, I guess... Ah, come on. Actually have the same items. That's kind of weird. Can I walk under the table? Yes, I can. Cool. She's green-haired.
Hey, Saga. Are you up and about? Does Papa know you're here? I don't think Papa knows. Don't worry. It'll be our little secret.
Need something to stand on. Well, Mama is cool with us being out and about, I guess. Can we find something to stand on? That's the question. Let's see.
Hey, baby, Mama's working. Give me a minute.
Oh, is that something I can pick up? Or are those too heavy? Can't pick them up. Okay, fair enough. It's not easy being tiny. Not easy at all. Can't pick those up. I can actually stand on that, but I can't. Was that just glitching? It looks like it might be just glitching, but... Can't I just... pull it? No, I guess not.
One second, Saga. I'm just finishing this one sentence. Almost. Almost. There. Right. What do you want? Did you want something? The door? You want me to open the door for you? I can do that. There you go. Now, don't go into the fireplace again and get ashes all over the place, okay? Where was I?
Thanks, Mama.
Hello, Saga. You're growing so fast, little one.
You're kind of freaky.
Soon you will talk and remember and see with other eyes. Eyes that can no longer see me. There's so much of me in you, sister daughter. I know you cannot understand me now, but I want you to know that I will watch you and protect you. Over time, our link will weaken, and you will be blind to me. But I will still be right here. Tomorrow, in 10 years, for as long as you live. And at the end, my sister, my daughter, we will reunite. The circle will be complete. The worlds rejoined, balance restored. The stories we will tell each other. I'll see you soon, my little Saga. May the balance be with you always.
Who are you talking to, Saga? What's all the babbling about?
Is she in there? How in the stars did she get out?
Magic, honey. It sounded like she was talking to someone.
Hey, how did you get out, baby girl? Did you sprout wings and fly?
There's someone else in the house, Magnus. I can feel it.
I don't feel anything. Don't worry, Etta. No one but us could ever get inside. It's impossible.
I hope you're right. I could have sworn there was somebody.
Oh, Papa's not the only one making stew.
Interesting. Very interesting. Ah, cool! That was the entirety of book one. Can't wait for book two. I know they've announced the date of book two, but I don't remember. She has to start down a new path to find a job unrelated to my studies. Oh, hello. Someone you've yet to meet. Come back to haunt me very soon, yeah, of course. Interesting. I like that you get a summary of your choices. This is going to be very interesting. Can barely wait for book two. As I said, they have actually come out with a date for book two, but I don't remember on the top of my head when it was, but I'm really looking forward to it. Yes! I like this. I hope you have enjoyed the book one so far, and looking forward to book two as much as I am. So, as always, thank you very much for watching, and tune in to the next one.